الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى حمدا كثيرا ونسبحه بكرة وأصيلا ونصلي ونسلم على خير خلقه وخاتم رسله مبعوث الحق بالحق ليظهر الله دينه على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون ولو كره المجرمون. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة، فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. Brothers, before we start, I want to just to send a message in your name to congratulate our Libyan brothers and sisters for the recent joint agreement between the acknowledged, recognized government and the rebellious sections who are following the General Haftar. They agreed to have a ceasefire, to start selling the oil, and to put the revenues in an account they both recognize, and that this account will not be touched until they form a unity government where everybody is represented. This is a good step. We should always, as an ummah, think of unity is the foundation of any community. Disunity is the foundation of weakness and helplessness. We look at another side, the other capital, Beirut, and I forgot to talk about it for the couple of weeks since it happened. Beirut and what happens in Beirut, and before the explosion in Beirut, Lebanon was exploding from within because it is a nation that was made by a cut and paste of opposing communities, interests, sects, and shapes and shades of communities. And anything that you form by force is easy to break down by any force. If you fasten or tie anything by force, as soon as the pressure of that force is lifted, it's easy to unravel. Let us pray to Libya, for Libya, that Allah will reconcile between all the elements of the society and make Libya whole again with peace and prosperity. And let us pray for Lebanon to see its way into the future, that their way with Islam as a foundation for everybody is much better than their way as factions manipulated, as we can see, by all foreign elements who see it as a prey, and everybody wants to snatch a piece away from the body. So let us pray for Lebanon as well to be united and to be a whole and to see its future in submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma ameen. This is our second session on the topic of the Quran. We spoke last time about the Quran and we picked some ayat that talk about the Quran to give us some view into what this book is really for. We spoke about the Quran, the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the guidance. And today, I'm going to take you into some other ayat from the Quran to complete the topic. The topic is, I hope, is of interest to everybody, because this is our book that we need to live by and take guidance from. So whatever the book says should be of interest to us. So let us start today with a hadith by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam talking about the Quran. In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, "Huwa hablullahi al-mateen." It is the strongest robe that Allah has sent down for you to hold on to. We explained that concept last time. So I hope you can refer back to last week's khutbah. هو حبل الله المتين والذكر الحكيم. It is a wise reminder. It comes from the wisdom of Allah, which is eternal, absolute, and unlimited. There is no comparison. والذكر الحكيم. It is a wise reminder. والصراط المستقيم. It is the straight path. We tell Allah in Al-Fatiha, اهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ, guide us to the straight path 17 times at minimum, every day. We're asking him for that. And every day he is telling us, this book is the guidance you are seeking. This is the guidance. وَالصِّرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ هُوَ الَّذِي لَا تَزِيغُ مَعَهُ الْأَهْوَاءُ. It is the source with which whims and desires should never conflict. And they should never supersede or bypass the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever you have of wrong emotions, wrong feelings, or fears, or concerns, if you bring all of this to the Quran, you will never get lost. لا تزيغ معه الأهواء ولا يمله الأتقياء. Righteous people never get bored reading the Quran, memorizing the Quran, reviewing the Quran, studying the Quran, or living the Quran. ولا يمله الأتقياء. If your heart is a righteous heart, you never feel bored. You never feel bored reading the Quran, no matter how long it may be. In fact, it is the opposite. It is the opposite. One of the seven people that the Prophet ﷺ tells us will be shaded in the shade of Allah on the Day of Judgment, رَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. His heart is hanging in the mosques. كلما خرج منها حن ليعود إليها. Whenever he leaves, his heart is here. So he is planning his next coming. When am I coming back? The Quran is the same because it is from Allah. Allah is the center of the universe. He is the one who is holding everything together. Whenever you stray away from him, if your heart is set in the right place, you always have the excitement to come back to Allah, to repent, to correct, to relearn what you're missing, to redirect your life. So the Quran is like the masjid. Some of us love the masjid more than the Quran. And some Muslims love the Quran more than the masjid. If you love the Quran, you should love the masjid the same way. If you love the masjid, you should love the Quran the same way. Both are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Muslim, whenever he or she leaves the Quran, they are looking, when is the next time to reopen the book? And scholars have said a lot of stuff about loving the Quran and living the Quran. We'll talk about those sometime, inshallah, in the future, if Allah wills. So, هو الذي لا تزيغ معه الأهواء ولا يمله الأتقياء ولا يخلق على كثرة الرد. I want you to think about this. The Quran is never too old to address modern needs. Why? Because the Quran is as eternal as it is source. The Quran will continue to give until the Day of Judgment. And what he gives, what Allah gives through the Quran, will continue to be very fit for every need, for every community, for every individual human being, for every society, until the Day of Judgment. So it's never too old. As if the Prophet ﷺ in this statement is responding to people who are hammering our ears in the media, saying the Quran is 1400 years old, let us get something modern. Other religious communities reformed their books, that's why they are advancing. No, it has nothing to do with their book. In reality, if you ask them, and they have written books about this for over 700 years ago, they have written books that they only advanced after they put the church in a corner and their books in the same corner. So it is not their book or their reform of their book that made them advance. It is that they have followed reasons for material advancement. And Allah told us in the Quran, كُلَّن نُمِدُّ هَؤُلَاءِ وَهَؤُلَاءِ مِنْ عَطَاءِ رَبِّكَ. Say, O Muhammad, we supply and provide the righteous and the wicked. Have you ever seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala limiting the provision of a community because they rejected his book or as a prophet? No. They continue to get their provision, right? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hadith, he says, if this life is worthy or equal to the value of a wing of a gnat, Allah would not have given a disbeliever a sip of water. لو كانت الدنيا تساوي عند الله جناح بعوضة ما سقى الكافر منها شربة ماء. So Allah's giving is not a sign that He is accepting what you're doing. He is giving you because you are His creature. Because He wants you to know that your life and whatever gifts you have in this life is from Him. So how would He do that if He were to take provisions away from people who disbelieve? They would disbelieve more. So Allah gives because He is Al-Wahhab. It is part of His holy names and holy attributes that He is the continuous, unlimited giver who gives for free. He gives for free in this life, but in the hereafter, you have to pay in advance right here. This is the formula. So some of us Muslims, when they hear the claims, the false claims that are coming, unfortunately, mostly from Muslim sources, including, by the way, Muslim scholars who were negatively impressed when they visited the West and they saw how clean their streets are, how their life is vastly organized. They are very good with managing resources and advancing in science and technology. And they say, we have seen Muslims without Islam, and in our countries, we see Islam, which is the book and the Quran, without Muslims. What they meant was that the West is too advanced and the East or the Middle East or the Muslim nations are too backward because they are not applying Islam. But their usage of the West advancement as a key has misled, unfortunately, many Muslims to think that they are advanced because they have reformed their books. They have limited the space for Allah, for His prophets, for His guidance, for His book, to your heart and your home. And this is what secularism is about. It is to tell Allah, you have your space, leave us ours. Your space in the church, the synagogue, or the mosque, the rest is ours to manage it the way we want to. So Muslims should not learn the wrong lesson. So continue with the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, "Fihi khabaru ma qablakum." It has all the news of the communities that came before you. Very clearly, if we study the history, as we are taught the history from the one who made history what it was, Allah, we will learn history the right way. If we read the history as written by man, man's hands have never produced anything perfect. That's why the engine we used when Ford started the first car is not the engine we use today. It always has faults and improvements to make. But the first man Allah created is the same man living here today, and the same man will be living here thousands of years from now if Allah extends this life. And the same creation still has all the capacities that the first man had, plus whatever man discovers of capacities that are still hidden inside us. So the Quran addresses this issue in a very simple but profound statement. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْأَفَاقِ. We will continue to show them our signs, both in the horizons. You know what horizons are? Horizons are realms, spaces, areas, spheres, fields. These are the horizons. So if it is the field of science, the field of technology, the field of medicine, the field of biology, Allah is promising, we will continue to show them our signs in these fields and horizons, and all fields are included. So Allah is making good. He is showing us a better future by opening our eyes to possibilities. Now we are fighting the tiniest of creatures for humanity to survive, so that we are not arrogant, so that we don't become boastful. Invisible creature can turn our life upside down. So that Allah continues also, as He is showing us His signs and infusing some of His gifts to us, so that we build every day a better future, Allah continues to also show us our weakness. And His signs are not limited to those fields. He says, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْآفَاقِ وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ, and in themselves. We continue to discover something called the immunity system, something called the genome, the composite of genes in the human body. Amazing discoveries to tell us that we are more complicated than any machine we humans create and want to brag about. Don't brag. Make the most sophisticated super computers, but rest assured, the computer inside you that is made by Allah, which is your inside components, are more complicated than you can even understand, let alone copy. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, حتى إذا أخذت الأرض زخرفها وزينت, until the earth is so lavishly decorated and it took its ornaments, it put all of its beauty on display. وَظَنَّ أَهْلُهَا, and its inhabitants, which is humanity, وَظَنَّ أَهْلُهَا, they thought they are in control. أنهم قادرون عليها. Then what happened? أتاها أمرنا. Our decree comes upon it. فجعلناها حصيدا كأن لم تغن بالأمس. So there will be a point when humanity reaches so much advancement that we humans would think then that we are in control. We can run the clouds. We can fly saucers. We can reach to the moon, which we are told we did. We can reach to Mars. And we sent some rover machines up there. And we will keep flying to all horizons to discover. We will keep digging and dive deep into the human body. But let me tell you something. With all the knowledge we have already accomplished and achieved, and the advancements and the developments, the human soul, I'm not talking about a ruh, I'm talking about a nafs. To study that human psyche is still baby steps. And in that field in particular, we are living by trial and error. Absolutely, trial and error. Talk to psychiatrists, talk to psychologists, talk to psychotherapists, and they will tell you the same. We are still in a baby step level, trying to discover what motivates us humans, in what direction, and how. How do we think? How do our impulses work? How do our emotional reactions are built? All of these are still secrets. We will continue to discover until we think we have discovered everything, then this life will be finished. So, فيه خبر ما قبلكم. It tells you the news that happened before you, the history. وحكم ما بينكم. And the news that are current, it is in the Quran. It is in the Quran that a nation like the US will be roaming the earth with its fleets of ships and military equipment to show muscle and control. It is in the Quran. وحكم ما بينكم. What is the best judgment in matters you face today? And this statement is the most powerful miracle in the Quran. The language is a miracle. But the most powerful miracle, science is a huge miracle in the Quran. Whatever we discover in science, we go back to find the Quran has reference to it. Okay? But the most profound miracle in the Quran is it answers all of our needs today as it did 1442 years ago. What an amazing book. But why is it amazing when we know it is from Allah? Does Allah get old? Does he forget? Huh? Does he not know what his creation was going to do? Does he not know the resources, the earth that he created? He knows. And that's why he tells us, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. So, فِيهِ خَبَرُ مَا قَبْلَكُمْ وَحُكْمْ مَا بَيْنَكُمْ. It has all the news of history for people before you so that you can learn. And it does have the greatest answers to the most difficult challenges of your day. What else? وَنَبَأُ مَا بَعْدَكُمْ. It's an amazing book. And the news that is yet to happen in the future, it's all in the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us love the Quran and live with the Quran and live the Quran. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters, if Allah allows us, we will continue to try to make living with the Quran an attraction to every heart. This is the book of Allah. We believe in it, we love it, but we should live it. It is not enough to love it. It's only beneficial when you live it. Do you know, Allah is never absent. So He did not send us a will, right? But if any one of us looks back and tries to dig out the wills of his parents before they passed away and read some of their guidance, they are not coming back to tell us, but they squeezed their knowledge, their expertise, their hearts and minds to give us whatever advice or admonishment they had. Well, the Quran is called مَوْعِظَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. It's an admonishment from Allah. Take it for what it is. It is your way forward. In the hadith of the Prophet, if anyone seeks guidance in any book other than it, he will get lost. If anyone follows the Quran would lead them to paradise. If anyone deserts the Quran behind their back, it will keep pushing them in the right direction. And if they don't get in the right direction and put the Quran ahead of them as their guidance, it will push them to hellfire. It is like when you keep telling your son or daughter, don't do this, please do that, don't go here, please go here, and they keep going in the wrong direction, you know where they are heading. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep all of our children in the right path, in the right direction, and keep us on the path that is straight. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa qina wasrif anna sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma aqsim lana min khashyatika ma tahulu bi baynana wa bayna ma'siyatik, wa min ta'atika ma tuballighuna bihi jannatak, ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ربنا آمنا في أوطاننا وأصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا اللهم أصلح ذات بيننا اللهم اجمعنا على كتابك واجمعنا على سنة نبيك اللهم لا توفنا إلا وأنت راض عنا اللهم اختم لنا بخاتمة السعادة أجمعين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فستذكرون ما أقول لكم وأفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد وأقم الصلاة